forward directly beneath my shoulders, and I'm going to align my knees directly up over my ankles. So from a front-on view, I'm going to come up here, I'm going to squeeze the glutes. Now I can either maintain a neutral spine, where I'm looking straight up at the ceiling, or I can tuck my chin. I'm opting to tuck my chin for this exercise so I can see you as I talk. From here, we're going to hold the hips up high. I'm trying to maintain a nice tabletop surface. Pretend like I took a hot cup of coffee or your favorite wine or beer, and I'm putting it right on my waist. Okay? And from here, we're going to straighten and extend one leg. So I'm going to extend, I'm going to flex the foot, drive the heel into the front of the room, bring it down, and the other leg, extend. Now, I'm trying really hard to not let my hips drop as I extend. Alright, my hips aren't dropping, and I'm also not allowing my hips to sink and turn as I extend. Okay, so from the front on view, is how I'm going to maintain a neutral spine, looking up the ceiling, extend the leg, squeezing the glutes to keep the hips high. And that's what it looks like from a front view. From the side view, same thing. Fingers facing forwards, wrists directly beneath shoulders, knees directly above ankles. So my shoulders, my arms to my torso make a 90 degree, and my knees are bent 90 degrees. Going to keep my hips nice and high, neutral spine, your chin tucked. Raise the leg, lower down, extend the knee, lower down. I am not lifting my legs, all I'm doing is extending, so I'm not doing this. Alright? These are just knee extension and down. Knee extension and down. The biggest complaint I get on this exercise is people's wrists hurt. It bothers their wrists. In most cases, this is simply a wrist flexibility issue and can be overcome with stretching and through time. Unless your doctor's told you otherwise, or you have some carpal issues or some cysts, try to start out with your fingers facing forward and maintain for as long as you can. If you can maintain that position for 10 seconds today and then have to rotate your hands out so your fingers are going sideways or backwards, okay, try to get to 15 seconds tomorrow or 20 seconds the next day and consistently work on increasing that range of movement. And if you can't, for other reasons, let me know, we'll talk about it and we'll make modifications as required.